How's it going today, brew crafters? My homebrew buddies and sisters and people, I hope you're doing well. Today, we're going to talk about temperature controllers for homebrewing. A specific temperature controller, it's the Inkbird ITC-308 WiFi. Hello, my name is Mark from brewcrafter.com. As I mentioned, today we're going to be talking about the Inkbird ITC-308 Wi-Fi temperature controller. A little bit of backstory. I've been using Inkbird temperature controller products for pretty much ever since I started homebrewing. The first one that I used was the STC-1000 model, and it's wired up to a couple of receptacles that I wired together. It's a great product. It's been around for a long time, really inexpensive, but you do have to do some of the wiring yourself, and so it's not super convenient in that way. A number of years ago, Inkbird came out with the ITC-308. Now that one is a plug-and-play model where all of the cooling and heating receptacles are basically built into kind of like a little extension cord that comes out of the unit, and it's incredibly handy. The temperature probe is also hardwired into the unit, which has its pluses and minuses, which I'll talk about in a little while. But I've been using that one on my kegerator for a number of years now. It's performed great. And recently, very, very recently, at the time of this recording at least, Inkbird came out with a Wi-Fi connected version of the ITC-308. So I thought that's awesome. That would be great for my fermentation chamber, because with the Wi-Fi connectivity, you have the ability, using Inkbird's smartphone app, to get notified of low temperature alarms, high temperature alarms, and things like that. Here we go. Inkbird ITC-308 Wi-Fi. Let's take a look. A manual. Let's hope we don't need this. A warranty card. Let's hope we don't need this either. And here is the main unit. First glance, I mean, this thing looks pretty much identical to the original ITC-308. As I mentioned, it has sort of a little power strip connection, which has outlets for both the heating and cooling sides. The temperature controller is programmable, and you can set lower limits and upper limits of the desired temperature range that you want to maintain. And it will activate the relays inside this thing and in turn activate either the cooling or heating output to maintain that desired range inside your fermentation chamber, your kegerator, your keezer, or whatever else you're using it for. A lot of people also use these for, I think, aquariums and like lizard aquariums. I don't know what lizard habitat is actually called. I'm gonna go with lizard aquarium. So like I was saying, everything looks pretty much the same as the original 308, with the exception of a little bit of difference in some of the silk screening. There's a little Wi-Fi icon here and a little Wi-Fi print on the up button. Now, typically the set and the up and down buttons on this are used for navigating the internal menu structure and setting parameters, alarm levels, things like that. That's still the case with this model, but it looks like there's also some buttons and some additional functionality with relation to setting up the Wi-Fi. We also have the temperature probe. It's wound up here, and it's got a 5-foot cord hardwired into the unit, which you can stretch out and place inside your kegerator or keezer or fermentation chamber, whatever. As I mentioned, it is hardwired. It's fixed into the unit, and it can be a good thing or a bad thing. If it's hardwired like that, you can't really access it to lengthen it, shorten it, or make a custom length cable unless you actually want to cut the cable and, you know, add in a section or shorten the cable or anything like that. You have to splice the wire. So that, you know, depending on your use, may or may not matter. The other downside is that while the main controller has a 2-year warranty, the probe only has a 1-year warranty. So if the probe were to go bad, it's not easy to actually replace just the probe. That said, I've been using the original ITC-308 for you know, well over 2 years at this point. Still going strong, no problems with the temperature probe. I have seen some instances online where people have experienced temperature probe failures, but I should mention that in the cases that I've seen, it's usually been when people are putting the temperature probe inside a liquid, like a jar of water or oil, inside the chamber that they're monitoring. Now, the reason people do that is because that slows down the temperature swings and will prevent the temperature controller from cycling on and off either heating or cooling too fast. The downside, though, is that this probe is not rated to be submerged. It's not submersible. So most of the times that I've seen people having problems with the temperature probe, it's actually because they've submersed this thing and it's not designed to do that. So don't do that. And I think you'll be okay. Some of the things, some of the main features of this, besides the Wi-Fi connectivity, which we're about to get into, are the ability to have separate heating and cooling relays built right in. That's awesome. So you can use it to maintain a really pretty tight fermentation temperature, especially inside your chamber. You can display in either Celsius or Fahrenheit. There are programmable features like delays for compressors turning on. So if you've got a freezer or refrigerator plugged into this, it won't too rapidly cycle the compressor on whatever your refrigeration system is, which can be harmful to the compressor and lead to a shorter lifespan. So that's a good feature. All in all, it's really easy to use. It's really easy to set your set temperature levels and to set your temperature alarms to the built-in menu. It's all covered here in the manual. I'm already familiar with it because I've been using the 308 for so long. But it's really simple to use. You just keep pressing the set button until you get to the right parameter, and then you press up and down to change it. Pretty simple. So now let's talk about the Wi-Fi connectivity. This is pretty interesting to me. Now, you might be wondering, why do we need Wi-Fi for a temperature controller? For me, it's intriguing because it gives us the ability to remotely get notified of high or low temperature alarms. So if you've got this, let's say, connected to your fermentation chamber, and you're trying to keep it at, you know, 61 degrees Fahrenheit, and the temperature drops below 58, or if it goes above, you know, 67, you can get notified. I just chose those numbers at random. That's maybe the heating portion isn't working. For whatever reason, the temperature is outside the bounds that I've set, and I need to go investigate it. By getting notified on my smartphone, I can do that. So let's get into the actual setup. I have specifically waited to go through the setup process on this just so that I can see how easy it is, if I run into any hangups, and record all of it so that you guys can see if there's any sticking points and just how easy it really is. We'll find out. Okay, let's go ahead and kick off the Inkbird Smart app on my iPhone here. And I'm going to record this and we'll just go through the process. Now, one thing I did do is I already went through the process. The first time you open the app, it's going to prompt you to either log in or register for a new account. I registered for a new account. It's pretty basic stuff. I didn't want to bore you and make the video too long by showing, you know, all that stuff. So once that's done, looks like the first thing that it's prompting me to do is to create a family. So Inkbird has a number of other products besides just these types of temperature controllers that are used for temperature monitoring, some smart thermostats and things like that. So I have a feeling that's why they call it a family, and they have things like rooms and these other items. That's great. For my purposes, though, it's just for homebrewing. I don't have any of the other, you know, whole house like smart home Inkbird products. So let's see. It wants me to enter a family name. I'm just going to say Mark. Well, I don't have it in any of these rooms. I'm going to deselect these. I'm going to add a room, and it is in my garage. Okay. Well, it looks like it's got a weather forecast, or current weather conditions at least, and prompting me to add a device. So let's try that. And it gives me two different types of devices that are compatible. This looks like the C929, and what we have is the ITC-308 Wi-Fi. So, I'm going to add a device. Power on the device and confirm that indicator light rapidly blinks. So, I'm going to set my phone down. I'm going to plug in the unit. And I'm just going to do it right here for initial setup purposes, just so it's easier for me to record. And then I'll plug it in out in the garage later once I've got it set up. And what do we got here? Okay, so it's reading the current temperature, and the Wi-Fi indicator is blinking. It's blinking rapidly. I will say yes. Enter Wi-Fi password. Looks like it has already found a local Wi-Fi network, and it wants me to enter my password. Now, note here, it says only supports 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi networks. Most people have 2.4 gigahertz in their homes. A lot of people also have 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi, but if they do, there's usually a second 2.4 gigahertz network available in their router. You just may need to turn it on in your router settings. So be aware that it only supports 2.4 gigahertz, but for most people, that's not going to be an issue. So I'm going to go ahead and type in my password. And it is going to attempt to connect, I guess. Looks like the Wi-Fi indicator is still blinking. I've got a progress bar on the app. Device found, registered device to the smart cloud, initializing device. Okay, now the Wi-Fi indicator is solid, so it looks like it has hooked up, and all the items went green on the list. Device added successfully. Here we go. Cool, so the initial display, I've got the temperature reading, and I've got the ability to look at a temperature trend, which of course has no data yet because, you know, I haven't stored any data. I just plugged the thing in for the first time, and some settings. So here I can go in and actually apply all the settings of the unit without needing to go in and use the little tiny display and buttons on the Inkbird unit itself. So that's cool. Currently the set value is at 77, and that's why the heating LED is active. So I can change the set value. Let's say I only want it to heat up to 70 degrees. Now, presumably when I grab my temperature probe, I'm just gonna hold it tight in my hand here, and hopefully that'll warm it up enough that it'll turn off the heating output. Yep, so it just clicked over to over 70 degrees, and and it went into alarm, because you remember I had the alarm status set, and I got a little notification. Just clicked into cooling mode, and the app updated basically right at the exact same second that I heard the relay click in the heating in the cooling mode. Now I wonder if just by setting the high temperature value to something above the current reading temperature, it would cancel it. So I set it to 75. And that canceled the alarm. Yeah, right on my smartphone there, I can see real time as things change. When the temperature goes up and down, I'm getting the same reading right on my phone. And when it goes into heating or cooling mode, at the same time that I heard the relay click on the unit, I saw it updated on the screen. So, pretty cool. Also pretty nice to be able to set up the configuration options from right within the app, as opposed to having to navigate the little menus buttons on the unit itself. So that's a quick overview of the ITC-308 Wi-Fi from Inkbird. And if you want to see a full article and review on this unit and learn more about temperature controlling for homebrewing, be sure to check out brewcrafter.com. Don't remember what the URL to the article is. I'll just put a link in the description of this video, or just go to brewcrafter.com and search for Inkbird. That would probably work.